Hey again, everybody. My name is Tony Page. Welcome to another episode of Fishin Finatic. I'm here today with my buddy Jim Lister. We've been fishing together for, this will be our 25th year fishing together. If it's in the water, we'll catch it. We fly fish, we striper fish, we bass fish, we trout fish, we crappie fish. Again, if it's in the water, we'll catch it. So
we'll fish in a tub.
So stay tuned. Hopefully we get some good action, catch some good fish for you today. And just so everybody knows, if you're not familiar with fishing in general, all fishermen lie, right? Except for me and Jim, of course. I'm not real sure about him. All right, stay tuned.
Yeah. Had the big one on, and man, I would have got him, but he took my pole straight down to the bottom, leaving me with nothing but a big old story to tell. All here. A bad day of fishing beats a good day of anything.
So here's Jim trying out my new Panoptics by Garmin system. Had it set up and he was probably 2 minutes, pulled in a nice little crappie. So I can zoom in on the screen and get a feel for what he's looking at. There, you can actually see that little red mark on the bottom right is his jig.
There's a fish.
Yeah, and there's a fish coming in from the left.
There's more than one. Here he comes.
Keep him right above him. Look at that.
There he is.
Fish on.
This is cheap.
Yeah, nice crappie. Look at that. Well done.
The master.
But that counts as half mine since you're using my fish finder. That's the rules.
There's another one down there, Paige.
All right, go get him.
Get a hole in the ice here. See it? That's either two fish or a big one.
Zoom in on that. There goes your jig. Just kind of keep it about a foot or so above their head.
Yeah.
They're sight feeders and they like to attack from below. Got him. Little one. Not only marking, I'm catching. Huh? Not only marking them, I'm catching them. That's what we're here for, right? Yeah, nice little crappie. All right, that's my first one of the day. Jim's already got two of them on the ice. So I am using a little VMC. I think it's called a Pug Bug. I have a 13 fishing, it's called a bubble gum, which is a pink little minnow tail. Plastic, soft plastic. Okay, there it is. Always make sure that your jig is positioned, presented properly when you go down. So, see a little tail, how it just wobbles around? So when I get it down there, you'll see I just jiggle the rod tip. Some guys call that pounding, which doesn't really make a lot of sense. I just kind of barely jiggle it, wiggle the rod tip. Get that little tail fluttering. Fish can see that for quite a ways down there. So hopefully they'll come in and hit it. Get back down there. All right, so I just moved to another hole. Dropped my transducer and I am immediately seeing a couple of fish in 17 feet of water. They're sitting at about 14 and a half, maybe 15 feet. Dropping my jig down to them. See if they chase it up. Oh yeah, here comes one, he's interested. Got him. Oh, he's a little guy. Well, yeah, I think he's just a little one. Well, he's fighting pretty good. Oh, oh. There he is. He didn't want to come out of the hole. All right. I think there might be more down there, so get down and see what it looks like. Maybe I'll catch one of his close relatives. See my jig falling, but don't see anything else on the screen. Sometimes if they're just out of the sonar cone, they might see it on the drop and then come in. His friends must have moved on, and that's what I might do. I usually, even if I don't see anything on the screen right after something like that, I usually hang around for about 30 seconds. Again, this transducer puts down a sonar beam in a cone, so it's only like 2 inches wide, you know, the diameter of the transducer itself, and as it goes down to the bottom, it gets wider and wider and wider. So in 17 feet of water, I'm probably drawing a circle maybe, I don't know, 6, 7, 8 feet across at the most, at the very bottom. And then the higher up in the water column you get, the narrower that beam is. So if the fish are just hanging outside of that beam, they're not going to show up. And I don't see anybody showing up, so time for me to move on. All right, so I just moved to another hole. Put the transducer down. I did see a fish, but now he just kind of went away. So it could be right outside the cone. Trying a new tactic. Still have my tungsten jig head with that same light pink soft plastic, but I tipped it with a real small wax worm to give it some scent. Oh, here comes one. It's coming up to it. Oh, damn it. Missed him. Let me check my bait. Yep, sure enough. Took my wax worm. All right, let me reload and try it again. All right, so here's the wax worm that I'm going to put on. Basically, they're little maggots is what they are. You can see this jig does not have a very big hook. I'm just going to poke that little guy through the head. So it kind of hangs next to my tail like that. And again, check my presentation, stug up my knot, make sure it's kind of hanging horizontal. That wax worm kind of gives it some scent. Kind of represents a, you know, natural larvae or an insect that the crappie might otherwise bite. So let's get that bad boy down there and we'll see what happens. I am marking a fish down there. Let me get my jig down to the bottom and see what happens. 17.4 feet of water. He's suspended at about 16. Oh, dropping my jig. He's flying up to it. Flying up to it. I'm at 14 feet. There he is. Just like that. Got a white white jig head. Oh, oh.
Don't count. Broke your line?
Nope. It just shook off right at the hole. Yeah, and as Jim mentioned, that one doesn't count. And here comes Jake, another member of our motley crew, the crappie slayer. So Jim just moved to a new hole with the panoptics, dropped his jig down, and there was two or three fish. You could see him swimming in from the side. Yeah, lift your jig up and hold it about 2 feet, and then just kind of wiggle it and see if he follows it right up. A lot of times they will. There you got him.
God almighty.
Oh, look at that.
Jesus.
Oh, that's a nice one. That's a nice one.
Oh, man.
Is that 11, 12 inches maybe?
Look at that beauty.
Oh, yeah. All right, so I just moved to another hole. I'm marking a fish down at the bottom, but I switched up my bait a little bit. I don't know how well that's going to show up, but it's a pink and chartreuse tungsten jig head with an impulse skeleton minnow, bright pink, soft plastic on it. We'll see what happens. I mean, he hit it, finally, but there he is. Finally got him. Wow.
Pink, eh?
There he is. It's not a big one. What do you think, Jim? Oop. Out of my line here. Think he's a keeper?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
All right. He's good eating right there. Good eating size. All right. So once again, I moved to a new hole. Dropped my transducer. Or I am marking fish. Jake's running for a flag again. I'm going to point over that direction. Got him?
Yep.
Jake's got one on the tip up. Nice crappie?
Yep.
All right. Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah,
it's
a good one.
All right, so in the meantime, back to the ranch. There, one finally. Holy cow.
Got one. That's a good one.
Feels like a decent one. Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's what I like.
That is a nice one. There we go. Chartreuse and pink head with a bright pink minnow tail. Fish down there, so maybe I can catch another one out of that clan. Oh, one just flew up to my jig. He saw it dropping, but he didn't hit it. There he did.
Get him on the ice, Pedro.
Oh, another nice one. Yeah, I'm into him now. This is the fun part. Just barely got him by the lip. I'm still marking fish down there. Drop down one more time.
I got the darn thing coming up 2 feet off the bottom, but they won't hit it.
Oh, there he comes. He's coming up to it. Got him too. Oh, yeah. This is what crappie fish is all about right here. Yeah. Get into this. Oh, he popped right off. Move to a new hole and I see one down at the bottom. So I just dropped above him. No, it's not. There he is. Oh, it's another nice one.
Don't let him get away. Data.
All right, come on. There you go. All right, there is still more down there on the graph, so let's see what happens. All right, so we just wrapped up for day, getting off the ice. Had a pretty good day. Only spent about 3 hours actually fishing. We got, I believe, about 18 or 19 pretty decent sized keepers. A dozen or so go. Let them grow up and catch them another time. So until next time, see ya.
Bet you're going fishing all of the time. Baby going fishing too. Bet your life, your sweet wife will catch more fish than you. Many fish bites if you got good bait. Here's a little tip that I would like to relate. Many fish bites if you got good bait. I'm a going fishing, yes, I'm going fishing, and my baby going fishing too. I went on down to my favorite fishing hole, baby grabbed me a pole and a line. Threw my pole on and caught a 9-pound catfish. Now you know I brought him home for supper time. Prove it, any fish bites if you got good bait. Here's a little tip that I would like to relate. Many fish bites if you got good bait. I'm a going fishing, yes, I'm going fishing, and my baby going fishing too. Baby brother about to run me out of my mind. Say, can I go fishing with you?